Hello, my dear friends. So, today we are going to discuss some points regarding capital gain. As you know, under Section 14, we have already learned income of a person is computed under five heads and capital gain is the fourth head. From the last video of introduction of capital gain, we have already learned what is capital asset, assessment year, previous year, long-term capital gain, short-term capital gain, etc. What do you understand from this picture? Yes, our next topic that we are going to deal with is transfer. Transfer of a capital asset, Section 2, Clause 47. Transfer under Section 2, Clause 47 of Income Tax Act 1961, the term transfer has been defined as transfer in relation to a capital asset includes. So, these all are the inclusions to be considered as a transfer. First one, the sale, exchange or relinquishment of the asset. We already know that sale is a kind of transfer. We will sell something, say a house property, and indeed get an amount of consideration. So here transfer takes place. Next, exchange. So what do you mean by exchange? It includes what we say give and take policy. It is a tit for tat act. And finally, relinquishment of the asset. Here, relinquishment means giving up certain asset or rights in an asset for a particular consideration. So, take an example. A shareholder is having the right to subscribe certain shares, that is, right issue. Let us assume the market value of the share is rupees 100 and the right share value is rupees 80. The shareholder is actually not interested to issue those shares, and at the same time he is willing to give those shares to another person who may be a third party. So here the shareholder is having something called the right, and that third party can receive those shares with low issue price and give the shareholder some consideration which may be less than rupees 20. So here transfer takes place. Second one, the extinguishment of any rights therein. What do you mean by extinguishment, or what is an extinguisher? Yes, we may be having fire extinguishers in the buildings and so on. So what is the purpose of that? To put out the fire, light, etc. or to stop something. Here too the same meaning, that is, some things or asset may be having certain time limits or what is called the expiry date. So in order to take benefit from it, we need to do it before such a limit. So here we are forced to do some kind of transfer due to some limitations. In this case also, transfer takes place. Third one, that is the compulsory acquisition. Let's take an example. As our country is developing day by day, many new projects are taking place in our residential areas too. Like for building dams, highways, airports, etc. At that point of time, we are being forced to move from that locality, that particular locality or area by the government. And they acquire that land. That is compulsory acquisition and it is also a form of transfer. Fourth one, in case where the asset is converted by the owner thereof into or is treated by him as stock in trade of a business carried on by him, such conversion or treatment. In short, we can say it simply like conversion of capital asset into stock in trade. For better understanding, let me put an example. Just consider a person named Mr. Tarun. He bought 20 acres of land for building a hospital. But he actually was busy with some other things and time went off. But as the time runs, many new modern hospitals took up that area and its demand therein went down. So then he finally decided to just split off the land and sell it. So here, the primary or the first intention or the idea of Mr. Tarun was in the category of capital asset, and it's gradually changed. It was converted into stock in trade, which is also being considered as a transfer. Next, fifth one. Any transaction involving the allowing of the possession of any immovable property to be taken or retained in part performance of a contract of the nature referred to in Section 53A of the Transfer of Property Act 1882. So here, consider a group of 20 members together forming a cooperative society and buys a plot and builds some flats there. So let us assume that there are 20 flats and each 20 of the flats are allotted to each 20 members. That is, these members are considered as the deemed owners. And one day a person from the 20 member was having a cash shortage and was in need of money. The only thing that he have is the membership or right as a cooperative member. So he decided to give his membership to another person and take the so-called consideration. So here inform that person is giving his membership to another person, but in substance what is happening? Sale of immovable property. This is also considered as a transfer. Finally, the sixth one, maturity or redemption of a zero coupon bond. Any idea? We know that bonds are also called debt instruments, and in this case it is zero coupon bond. So here, what is the big deal in wasting money in such bonds? There must be something. Technically, no interest is being generated here. Let us take an example. Like Mr. A bought a bond which was having fair market value of rupees 100, and after 20 years, at the time of redemption, the value is as same as before, that is rupees 100 itself. So here, what is the point or what he earned during those years? At the time of purchase of the bond, he issued it at rupees 20, which is a deep discount, and in the viewpoint of him, he earned rupees 80, isn't it? So in this situation also, at the date of redemption, transfer takes place. After all these inclusions we have discussed already, these are some of the exclusions. There are certain transactions which are transfer but will not be treated as transfer for the purpose of taxation. Section 46 and Section 47 says about the exclusions of transfer. First one, distribution of assets to its shareholders on its liquidation. At the time of liquidation, certain transactions like the distribution of assets takes place to its shareholders, and those transactions are not considered as transfer. Second one, distribution of capital assets in Hindu undivided family to its members at the time of total or partial partition. In Hindu undivided family, at the time of partition, they may distribute capital assets to its members, and this is not considered as a transfer. Third one, transfer of a capital asset under a will or an irrevocable trust or a gift. Also, certain transactions like giving gifts, etc. are not considered as a transfer. So the fourth one, transfer of a capital asset by a company to its wholly owned Indian subsidiary company. And next one, transfer of a capital asset by a wholly owned subsidiary company to its Indian holding company. So here, fourth and fifth deals with the transactions taking between companies. That is, in the first case, it is between a company and wholly owned Indian subsidiary company. And in the second case, it is between wholly owned subsidiary company and an Indian holding company. So, actually, an element of logic should also be used in this calculation. This is the basic formula for the calculation of short-term capital gain. From sales consideration, we have to subtract the cost of acquisition, cost of improvement and selling expenses. And finally, we will get short-term capital gain. This is the formula for the calculation of long-term capital gain. Here, from sales consideration, we need to subtract indexed cost of acquisition, indexed cost of improvement and selling expenses, and finally we will get long-term capital gain. After looking this formula, we need to find out indexed cost of acquisition and indexed cost of improvement for our further calculations. So the formula for indexed cost of acquisition is equal to cost of acquisition into CII. What do you mean by CII? Cost of inflation index. So, cost of acquisition into CII of the year in which the asset is being transferred divided by CII of the year in which the asset was acquired, or CII of 2001-2, whichever is later. The formula for indexed cost of improvement is equal to cost of improvement into CII of the year in which the asset is being transferred divided by CII of the year in which the expenses of improving the asset were incurred. Next, we need to deeply look into some points before entering the problem part. Because cost of acquisition, of course, which is essential for calculation, is having a wide range and sometimes a bit confusing. But all you need is to study these rules, then it will be perfect. Under the cost of share security, which was acquired before 1st April 2001, the cost of acquisition is equal to actual cost of acquisition or fair market value as on 1st April 2001, whichever is higher. And when acquired after 1st April 2001, the cost of acquisition will be equal to the actual cost of acquisition. Under cost of bonus shares, when acquired before 1st April 2001, the cost of acquisition is equal to fair market value as on 1st April 2001. And when acquired after 1st April 2001, cost of acquisition is nil. Under cost of acquisition of goodwill, if goodwill is purchased from previous owner, the cost of acquisition will be equal to the purchase price. And when in the case covered under 49 clause 1, the cost of acquisition will be equal to the cost to the previous owner. In any other case, the cost of acquisition is nil. Example, internally generated goodwill. Under cost of right share, if the SSE subscribe to the right issue, the cost of acquisition will be equal to the amount actually paid. And when, if the SSE renounce the right to other person, the cost of acquisition will be nil. And when, if the SSE purchases the right to subscribe for additional share, the cost of acquisition will be equal to the purchase price for the right plus amount paid for acquiring additional share. Cost inflation index. We have already seen CII or cost of inflation index in the formula for computing cost of acquisition and cost of improvement. This is the chart showing the cost of inflation index till the financial year 2019-20. So, what is cost inflation index? Cost inflation index calculates the estimated rise in the cost of goods and assets year by year as a result of inflation. So, every year our economy is changing and many changes is taking place in the cost of goods, services, assets, etc. So, for assisting us to deal with the calculations of such things, we need this cost inflation index. It is fixed by the central government in its official gazette to measure inflation. Section 48 of the Indian Income Tax Act 1961 defines the index as notified by the government every year. The cost inflation index for the financial year 2019-20 has been notified by the Ministry of Finance. In a notification dated September 12, the Finance Ministry stated that CII for financial year 2019-20 has been set as 289. Is there anyone watching this video? Don't know what is inflation? Don't worry. Inflation refers to the rise in the price of most goods and services of daily or common use, such as food, clothing, housing, recreation, transport, consumer staples, etc. As time passes, the price level also changes. Inflation measures the average price change in a basket of commodities and services over time. In short, too much money chasing too few goods. Like in the example above, how inflation has changed the price of a cup of coffee over time. Look, in 1970 it was $0.25 and it eventually rises. Look, in 2019 it is $1.59. This is a very important current information about CII, that is, Cost Inflation Index for the financial year 2019-20 is notified as 289. Do you know life should not be a straight line, just like the heartbeat, that is, dead heartbeat. We need ups and downs in our life. So we need to experience and practice many things. So, next, we can fight with some problems and find the solutions. Only we need is some concentration and love for the subject. So, let's begin. X purchased a residential house for ₹2,26,000 in 2004-2005. He gifted the house to Y in 2008-2009. The fair market value of the house on the date of gift was ₹4,20,000. X files suit on Y claiming the title of the property. Y paid ₹50,000 to Z, compromising it, and Y sold the house on 10th December 2017 for ₹19 lakhs. Determine the capital gain for X and Y for the assessment year 2018-19, the CII in 2004-2005, 2008-2009 and 2017-2008 are 113, 137 and 272 respectively. ഇവിടെ X എന്ന് പറയുന്ന ഒരു വ്യക്തി ഒരു റെസിഡൻഷ്യൽ ഹൗസ് വാങ്ങുകയാണ്. അത് ഇയർ 2004-05 വർഷത്തിലാണ് വാങ്ങിയത്. അതിൻ്റെ വില അപ്പോൾ 226,000 ആയിരുന്നു. 2008-09 വർഷത്തിൽ എക്സ് എന്ന വ്യക്തി വൈ എന്ന വ്യക്തിക്ക് ആ റെസിഡൻഷ്യൽ ഹൗസ് ഗിഫ്റ്റായിട്ട് കൊടുത്തു. ആ സമയത്ത് ആ വീടിൻ്റെ വില അതായത് ഫെയർ മാർക്കറ്റ് വാല്യൂ 420,000 ആയിരുന്നു. But during that time, X files you on Y claiming the title of the property. Appo, Y ke kudal, he was not interested in fighting. So, Y decided, Y compensated che and decided idu. Adu kondu thanne, ₹50,000 Y Z ne koduthu. And pinneedu Y aa oru veedu 10 December 2017 le vilkugayundayi. For 1,900,000 rupees സെയിൽ നടന്നത്. ഇവിടെ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യൻ എന്താണെന്ന് വെച്ചിട്ടുണ്ടെങ്കിൽ ഡിറ്റർമൈൻ ദി ക്യാപിറ്റൽ ഗെയിൻ ഫോർ എക്സിൻ്റെയും വൈൻ്റെയും ക്യാപിറ്റൽ ഗെയിൻ കാണണം ഫോർ ദി അസസ്മെൻറ്റ് ഇയർ 2018-19. അതിനാവശ്യം കാൽക്കുലേഷൻ ആവശ്യമായിട്ടുള്ള സി ഐ ഐ 3 വർഷത്തെ ക്വസ്റ്റ്യനിൽ തന്നെ തന്നിട്ടുണ്ട്. സോ ഇവിടെ എക്സിൻ്റെയും വൈൻ്റെയും ക്യാപിറ്റൽ ഗെയിൻ കാണാനാണ് ക്വസ്റ്റ്യനിൽ പറഞ്ഞിരിക്കുന്നത്. വി ഹാവ് ഓൾറെഡി സ്റ്റഡീഡ് ഇൻ ദ കേസ് ഓഫ് ഒരു ഗിഫ്റ്റ് കൊടുക്കുന്ന ഒരു സന്ദർഭത്തിൽ അതായത് ദർ ഈസ് നോ നീഡ് ടു കമ്പ്യൂട്ട് ക്യാപിറ്റൽ ഗെയിൻ ഫോർ എക്സ് ആസ് ഹി ഹാസ് ഗിഫ്റ്റഡ് ഹിസ് പ്രോപ്പർട്ടി ടു വൈ വിച്ച് കനോട്ട് ബി കൺസിഡേർഡ് ആസ് എ ട്രാൻസ്ഫർ അതൊരു ട്രാൻസ്ഫർ അല്ല അതുകൊണ്ട് തന്നെ ഇതൊരു ക്യാപിറ്റൽ കാൽക്കുലേഷൻ ഓഫ് ക്യാപിറ്റൽ ഗെയിൻ ചെയ്യാൻ പറ്റില്ല So next we have to look whether it is short term capital gain or long term capital gain. As ഇത് പർച്ചേസ് ചെയ്ത ഇയർ 2008-09 ഇത് സെയിൽ ചെയ്ത ഇയർ 2017 ആയതുകൊണ്ട് ഇൻ ബിറ്റ്വീൻ ഇറ്റ് ഇസ് എ വൈഡ് ഡ്യൂറേഷൻ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് മോർ ദാൻ 9 years. So it is definitely a long term capital asset. So next we can calculate capital gain. Computation of capital gain of Y for the assessment year 2018-19. Firstly, sales consideration. In question, it is directly given 19 lakhs minus indexed cost of acquisition. Here, cost of acquisition, under cost of acquisition, a second 41 clause 1 is applicable here, that is cost of previous owner. So we should take 2,26,000 as the cost of acquisition. And in here we have to compute indexed cost of acquisition. Apo indexed cost of acquisition formula, cost of acquisition into CII of the year in which the asset is being transferred. Asset is being transferred. Transfer, asset transfer ചെയ്തിട്ടുള്ള വർഷത്തിലെ സി ഐ ഐ അതാണ് 272 and it is divided by the CII of the year in which the asset was acquired. Asset acquire ചെയ്ത വർഷത്തിൻ്റെ സി ഐ ഐ ദാറ്റ് ഇസ് 113 and by calculating it we will get 5,44,000 minus indexed cost of improvement. It is nil, it is not there in the question, minus selling expenses, it is also nil. So finally we will get long term capital gain, that is equal to 13,56,000. Next question, compute capital gain of Mr. X for the assessment year 2018-19. Equity shares purchased on 8/5/2017 is rupees 1 lakh and sold these shares in recognized stock exchange on 6/2/2018 for rupees 1,50,000. Trading brokerage is rupees 1,500 and securities transaction tax is rupees 300. So from the question it is clearly understood that the difference between the dates of purchase and sale is approximately 10 months and it is less than 12 months. So it is a short term capital asset. So now we can compute capital gain. So computation of capital gain of Mr. X for the assessment year 2018-19. First, sales consideration. It is directly given in the question 1,50,000. Minus cost of acquisition, which is directly given in the question, that is 1 lakh. Minus cost of improvement, it is nil, minus selling expense, that is 1,500, that is trading brokerage is a selling expense and securities transaction tax is not a selling expense, so we should exclude it. And finally, we will get short term capital gain, that is 48,500. Next question. From the following information, compute the capital gain for the assessment year 2018-19. Date of purchase. For house 1, it is on May 1997, house 2 on December 2000. Cost of acquisition. For house 1, it is 1,90,000. For house 2, it is 2,50,000. Cost of additional construction in 2000. For house 1 it is 10,000 and for house 2 it is 25,000. Fair market value on 1st April 2001 for house 1 is 1,75,000 and for house 2 is 3,50,000. cost of additional construction on 2014-15 for house 1 is 48,000, for house 2 is 1,20,000. Sale proceeds of property in 2017-18 for house 1 is 14 lakhs, for house 2 it is 24 lakhs, and CII of 3 years and their respective indexes are also given. In this question, there is a vast difference between the purchase date and the sale date, so it is definitely a long-term capital asset. So the answer, computation of capital gain for the assessment year 2018-19. We can do in one single table itself. Firstly, sales consideration. The sales consideration of house 1, it is directly given in the question, it is 14 lakh. At the same time, for house 2, it is 24 lakh. Minus indexed cost of acquisition. So, we need to calculate the indexed cost of acquisition with the formula. For taking cost of acquisition, we need to take some condition. There is some condition here. That is, cost of acquisition or fair market value, whichever is higher. So, here under house 1, the cost of acquisition is 1,90,000 and fair market value is 1,75,000. So, the higher amount is the cost of acquisition, that is 1,90,000. So, we need to take 1,90,000 as cost of acquisition, which is into CII of the year in which the asset is being transferred, that is 272, which is divided by the CII of the year in which the asset was acquired, that is 100. This is in the case of house 1. In the case of house 2, cost of acquisition or fair market value, whichever is higher. Under house 2, cost of acquisition is 2,50,000 and the fair market value is 3,50,000. So here, fair market value is the highest amount. So we need to take 3,50,000 into CII of the year in which the asset is being transferred, that is 272 divided by the CII of the year in which the asset was acquired, that is 100. So we will get the answers. For house 1, we will get 5,16,800 by applying this equation, and for house 2, we will get 9,52,000. As same in the case of indexed cost of improvement. The formula for computing cost of improvement, indexed cost of improvement, is that cost of improvement into CII of the year in which the asset is being transferred divided by CII of the year in which the expenses of improving the asset were incurred. In the question, cost of additional construction in 2000 is given, but we cannot take it because it is before 2001. So we should eliminate that. And we should take the cost of additional construction in 2014-15. That is 48,000 and 1,20,000. So under house 1, 48,000 into 272 divided by 240 is the CII of the year in which the expenses of improving the asset were incurred, and in house 2 it is 1,20,000 into 272 divided by 240, and we will get under house 1 54,400 and under house 2 1,36,000. Selling expenses is nil in both the cases. And finally, we will get long-term capital gain, that is for house 1, 8,28,800 and for house 2, it is 13,12,000. Next question. Mr. Arun sold jewelry for rupees 1 lakh in May 2017 and its cost of acquisition was rupees 80,000 in June 2015. Calculate the capital gain for the assessment year 2017-18. So, it is a short-term capital gain. How? Because the duration between the purchase or the acquisition date and the sales year, it is less than 36 months. So it is a short-term capital gain. Next, calculating the capital gain for the assessment year 2017-18. First, sales consideration, that is 1 lakh, it is directly given in the question, minus cost of acquisition, which is 80,000, minus cost of improvement, nil, which is not given in the question, minus selling expenses, nil. There is no other selling expenses being explained in the question. And finally, we will get the short-term capital gain, that is 20,000. So just work out with more and more problems. I'm Divyanjali, MD, 2nd MCom Finance, studying in MES Asmabi College. Hope everyone understood the presentation. Thank you.